Global Talk Series, a joint venture of Government Engineering College Bilaspur and alumni of Bilaspur GP Daddy Bradley. I, DP Singh, Assistant Professor of Electrical Engineering Department, happily welcome you all on the 8th session of Global Talk Series. Today, our topic is Oil and Gas Carriers and Future Prospects, presented by Mr. Ved Prakash Mahawar, former Director Onshore ONGC and OMPL, and our 1980 batch alumni of mechanical engineering. He possesses more than 35 years of vast experience of managing, drilling, and operational functional, holding various key positions across vast spectrum of oil field activities. As a mechanical engineer graduate, he started his career with ONGC as a drilling engineer in 1982. He is also known as first subsea engineer of ONGC. He has, to his credit, more than 25 papers presented in international conferences. He also developed well-controlled manual for offshore operation and was part of the team to develop OIST standard 174 for well-controlled practices. In August 2015, he took over as director onshore of ONGC. Later on, he was also nominated as a member of society and Board of Governors, IIM Rohtak, in January 2017 by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. He received the prestigious CEPM Fellowship Award for the year 2016 for his excellent and outstanding contribution in area of project and risk management. This award was also in recognition of his leadership, dedication, and commitment to make ONGC a world-class organization on following scientific project management methodology. Sir, I extend a warm welcome to you and we are truly honored to have you with us.
Thank you, thank you. You got a lot of information about me. मैं विवेक से पूछ रहा था कि भाई कुछ चाहिए क्या, बोले नहीं सर आपका हम लोग ढूंढ लेंगे. Thank you.
I now request Mr. Umesh Srivastav, Head Operation and Maintenance, Ultra Deck Cement and National Coordinator of Global Talk Series to address the gathering. Umesh sir, please.
Yeah. Good morning Chawla sir. Good morning Divakar Mishra sir, our HODs, professors and dear students. So welcome all of you in another lecture of the Global Talk Series. And it is a matter of great honor for all of us to have Sri Ved Prakash Mahawar, former ONGC director, and he has earned a lot of laurels in his career. And DP has covered most of them, which I have also collected from the social media. So I think I should not repeat all those things. In fact, I will like to welcome our brightest star, Sri Mahawar sir, who had studied in this college, and he's from the batch of 1980. We will be hearing about the oil and gas scenario and the future prospects from Sri Mahawar today. And this is a topic of utmost importance for any country which has to import huge quantum of energy needs from outside. So I request you all to focus on the learnings today and use it for our future development. So thank you. Thank you, DP. You please continue with the further process.
Thank you so much, sir. You don't have to be great to start, but you have to start to be great. With these lines, I would like to invite Dr. B.S. Chawla, Principal GEC Bilaspur, to deliver welcome address. Sir, please.
Thank you, Deepi. Aaj ke technical talk, oil and gas scenario, future prospects ke key speaker, mere senior Sri VP Mahawar sahab, karyakram ke mukhya atithi Sri Divakar Mishra sahab, कार्यक्रम में विशेष रूप से उपस्थित मेरे मित्र श्री सुशील सिन्हा जी जो आज के टेक्निकल टॉक को समअप करेंगे और अन्य एलुमनी में श्री दीक्षित जी, अर्चना लाखे हमारी स्टूडेंट पहली बार दिख रही हैं बॉम्बे से, और सभी एलुमनी और प्रिय मेरे कलीग्स, मेरे स्टूडेंट्स और ऑडियंस, आप सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत.
थैंक यू सर.
टॉपिक बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है, बहुत रिलेवेंट टॉपिक है जिसपे महावर साहब बात करेंगे. महावर साहब को सुनने का सौभाग्य हम लोग को मिल रहा है, ये अपने आप में बहुत विशेष बात है. हम लोग जैसा महावर साहब को याद करते हैं, मैं आपको बोलचाल की अपनी भाषा में बताना चाहूंगा, एक सुदर्शन व्यक्तित्व के धनी, मेरे इमीडिएट सीनियर और बहुत हम्बल सरल व्यक्तित्व के, छत्तीसगढ़ के बहुत इंटीरियर एक गाँव को बिलोंग करने वाले और बहुत ऊंचाइयों तक पहुंचने वाले भाग्यशाली एलुमनी के रूप में हम लोग महावर साहब को याद करते हैं। महावर साहब आज रिटायरमेंट के बाद भी अभी एक जो डिजास्टर हुआ नॉर्थ ईस्ट में, वहां पर उनको स्पेशल कॉल किया गया। ये अपने आप में दर्शाता है उनका कमिटमेंट, उनकी टेक्निकल कॉम्पिटेंसी, उनका जुझारूपन। और वो उन्होंने उससे ना नहीं कहा कि मैं रोल में नहीं हूँ, उन्होंने सब छोड़कर देश को पहले चुना और मौके पर पहुँच कर अभी भी यूनिफॉर्म में हैं वो और वहाँ लड़ रहे हैं उस भीषण त्रासदी से देश को बाहर निकालने के लिए। वे अपने तन मन धन से वहाँ जूझ रहे हैं। हम लोग आपकी सफलता की कामना करते हैं सर। आज का आपका ये जो टेक्निकल टॉक है, ये हमारे बच्चों को नई सोच देगा और ऑयल एंड गैस फील्ड के बारे में हम लोग नई जानकारियाँ प्राप्त करेंगे आपसे। इन आशाओं के साथ आपका पुनः स्वागत, धन्यवाद सर।
Now, it's a great privilege to invite our Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Divakar Mishra, retired IFS officer, State Project Administrator, SPIU, to say a few words. Sir, please.
Good morning to all.
Morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Dr. Chawla, all the distinguished alumni, faculty and students. I am very happy to be present in this webinar. And during these challenging times in the first phase of lockdown, one interesting thing happened. The oil prices plunged to their lowest levels. So many countries, including India, rushed up to fill up all their storage tanks and everything. Because of the lockdown, travel and any movement were prohibited. So that was a thing. Second thing which all of you have mentioned, the oil fire in Assam. So since I am not a technical person, I will like to know what are the causes and how can we control it effectively. Another thing, I want to request that in these challenging times, it is very necessary to keep up a dialogue with the students, because most of the students are stressed about their studies, exams, placements and other things. So a constant dialogue is necessary with the students and faculty also, because many of them are being asked to do online. Most of them may be conversant, but maybe some of them need some time to get used to the new technology. And since GEC Bilaspur has a very distinguished and illustrious alumni, I would like to request one personal thing, that those who have been blessed by God with lot of position and resources, they must place at least 10 students in their organization. And if in these challenging times it is difficult for placements, at least they can take the students on internship. So a minimum of 10 students will be very beneficial for the student, and who knows, some of them may turn out to be like Mahavarji, Umesh, Ashish, Prabir, lot of others, and some of them may excel also. So we never know. And the best thing will be that some of these students may again try to help their juniors. So you will be passing on a legacy to them, and it will go from generation to generation. And the bonding of the family of GEC Bilaspur will become very strong. This is my personal request, and I hope the distinguished and illustrious alumni will make note of it and do their best for the students. Thank you very much.
Noted, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Sir, just before we start, I'll just, thank you so much, sir. I just introduce Sanjeev Sani is our also from college from 2000 batch, and today he's also in oil and gas. So as Mahavar sir is there, so especially he has come to just join us.
Aapka swagat hai.
Namaskar. Of the team, and really it's highly motivated and integrated. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to join this team.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Just a little housekeeping before we get started. If you have any question during the presentation, you can type them into the chat box. If you want, you can also raise your hand for the same. Please fill the feedback form at the end of the session. Your remarks and suggestions are valuable for us. Now, without further ado, I will turn the time over to our presenter, Mr. VP Mahawar. Sir, I kindly request you to start the session.
Okay, friends, good morning to all of you, and I thank all of you for speaking some of the good words for me. I don't know if that's going to affect me any, but I'm doing my duty, and whatever is taught by my Gurujis, I'm carrying forward that. I can say that's all. And for this session, I have a session put it like that. I'll be talking about the energy scenario worldwide and India, oil production worldwide and India. So we can compare where we stand today in our country and what is happening on the oil and gas scenario. And I'll be talking about the future of oil and gas, because people talk about e-vehicles and so many things. Oil will not be dependent on oil and all these things. So these things I'll be definitely touching. I'll be talking about some of the learnings which I have gained in my 36 years of career, which has helped me to gain this position which I was. And one request to all my junior friends, colleagues, and college mates were studying or was already in some of the places, ask questions, which is very important. And sometimes, normally I say one thing, there is no question is a silly question. So don't think if I'm asking those questions, what he will feel or her, what she will feel. So don't have that inhibition in your mind. Whatever is coming to your mind, please come up. Question is a question. There's no silly question or good question, it's a question. So that, with that mindset, you all sit here and discuss with me. I'm very open, free, and whatever I know, I'll definitely share with you, and what is in my mind and what I think about this industry, and what will be the future of my country, that will also definitely going to discuss with you all, whatever the perspective, what I have and what I have gained in this 36 year of career. And just briefly touched about, already you have told me that but I have worked in all the places in the country. I joined in Mumbai, I was in offshore, then I was in Chennai for a few years, then I was in Andaman for 3 years, I was in Rajahmundry for another 2 years, I was posted in Dehradun, so I brought a world-class well-controlled school, IWC of in India, first time. And then I was in Assam for 6 years, handling one of the difficult field where we're drilling up to 5 kilometers down the earth. So those kind of challenges were there, so I was there. And then after that, I was brought to Ahmedabad. I was looking after the crisis management of ONGC India and OVL ONGC Videsh. So this was my turn. After that, I have been given a challenge to start one of the 726 megawatt power plant in Northeast, first of its kind. So that was also started and dedicated to the nation by our Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji. So I received him there, and he inaugurated that. After that, I was selected as director, and the challenge was the production of oil and gas was coming down every year at the rate of about 2 to 3%. And when I took over, it was 7 to 8% was the down was there. But with the learnings which I gained and the confidence, the basics which I learned in my college has given me the confidence, and that production has reversed and it has increased by 3 to 4%. And my commitment was 7%, so 7 plus 3 is 10%. So I achieved that. So whatever commitment I have given, I have achieved in my life. So that is one thing. And regarding this fire, I'll just show some of the pictures later on. A later part, but let me start with the this presentation. Whatever it is told to me by Vivek, I'm just going to click that and coming to the presentation. I think, is it visible to all of you? चलिए आई थिंक किसी को नहीं थे मुझे पता क्योंकि विवेक हैज टोल्ड मी जो मुझे उसने बताया मैं वो करते जा रहा हूँ million metric tons of oil equivalent. So it is 13,864 million metric tons is consumed by world every year. But India is consuming about 809 MMT. So now you can see in the terms of percentage, it's about 6%. But if you see the oil, gas, coal, nuclear, and hydro and renewables, if you see the world's statistics and Indian statistics, why I'm giving this? Because one, we should understand how much we are dependent on coal. Till today, if you see more than 50%, of our energy is coming from coal, although the coal is coming from ages, but still we are dependent on coal, that too more than 50%, whereas the world is dependent about this 7.8%. So see the difference between that. And other things, if you see oil and gas worldwide, almost 50% is oil and gas, but India, it is not 50%, it's about 33-34%. So now you see the gap between, and here what I'm trying to tell you that we are talking about e-vehicles, the things will come and our pollution levels will go down. It is not. We have to see the things in totality. If you are producing electricity with coal and using that electricity for the vehicle, it means in totality, if you see the CO2 emission is more than what we, if you are producing electricity from the oil and gas. So this scenario people have to understand very well. Ki e-vehicle aa jayega, pollution kam ho jayega. No, it's not like that. Unless until we get rid of this whole business, the pollution levels will not come. So it is not wise to produce electricity from the coal and use e-vehicles. No, it's not like that. So everything we have to see in totality. Now, I was discussing this with one of my friend from IIT Kharagpur, Sagarwal. He was talking to me and told me that there are research going on with the IC engines efficiency, they are planning to go even up to 64-70%. If an IC engine of that efficiency comes in the market, then you can see what will happen to the e-vehicles. So this is a scenario I'm giving you, and the sharings or learnings which I have got from my seniors, on my junior colleagues and my friends, I'm sharing with you. So this slide I have shown this is there. If you see the oil consumption, it's 4600, but what is our consumption? It's 239. I'm coming to the next slide, which is more important. If you see the worldwide oil reserves, which is availability of oil worldwide, which we can produce. The oil is much more than available. If you see, the reserves is about 244,000 MMT million metric ton. MMT means million metric ton. But if you see in India, it is only 400 MMT. And India, we have 26 basins where the oil deposits are, oil and gas are available, but only we could search oil in 8 basins only till today. So there's a lot of scope there. So we can further enhance our oil recovery and oil production by searching for oil in other basins. If you see the worldwide scenario where the reserves are available, Venezuela is number one, Saudi Arabia, Canada, and these are the countries where you see a lot of oil is available, mostly about 50%. If you see OPEC countries, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, they have almost 71% of the oil reserves with them. That's why you see the OPEC was governing, but the USA came in between. They started enhancing their production because of the shale oil. So during that period, the OPEC significance was reduced, but again, after this COVID and all, if you see, the OPEC is playing a very big role. And if you see in the OPEC, there are 15 countries and they have the major stake with them. Now, if you see the oil production and consumption scenario worldwide, world is producing almost 97 million barrels of oil per day, but at present they are producing about 70% of it, but now it is picking up. If you see the yesterday figure, we have come back to almost 87-89% of the oil production which we are producing before the COVID thing, and India is only producing 870,000 barrels. Now you see, it's not even 0.5%. And world production is 4,475 million metric ton. India is producing only 34.5%. But our consumptions are different. I'll just talk to you. I think I have one slide on that. Or others, I can tell you the consumption. We are consuming almost 239 million metric tons of oil every year, whereas production is only 34.5. It's only 14%. Means 86% of the oil we are importing from outside. So you know, now you can see that our import deficit is because of this oil mostly. So and this oil is going to remain for longer time. We can't see that we will not produce in India and we'll only import. No, that will not happen because we have find that countries with the highest of this. PM is also talking many times that why we cannot increase the production. And he has given a task by 2022, we should enhance our oil by 10%, which is a Herculean task. Which is not going to, or we have to reduce our import by 10%, which is a very, very, very tough target. So will not be achieved in the present scenario. Now, if you see the oil refinery capacities, refining capacity, because some of you might be having carriers in refining, some of you, because this oil industry is a very risky business, but refining side is quite comfortable. If you see the oil refining capacity, it is worldwide is 100 million barrels, where we are producing only 97. So we have enough capacity available. If India throughput, if you see throughput means how much capacity we have, it's 5.1 million barrels per day, which is almost equivalent to our consumption in India. But worldwide, the refineries which are working, they are almost not able to refine the complete product 97%. It's only 85 million barrels per day, that kind of refining capacity, which is working as on today. Now, I'm talking about the gas reserve scenario, what is there in the gas reserve? Because why I'm talking about gas, India, if you see in the energy basket, only 3-4%, exactly 3.7% gas in our energy basket. But whereas the world average is more than 19%. So reaching to that level, even we have not planned. If you see any of the energy report, anybody is talking about energy, even if you are talking about 2040 scenario, we are talking about 8% of the gas in total energy basket, which is very, very less, because gas is the one of the cleanest fluid, which one should know that. Amongst all, that is one of the, apart from renewables, this is the one of the cleanest fluid. But still, we are not talking about the world average of about 90%. We are talking about only 8% in 2040. So see the scenario. So this is the way the energy basket will be for us. Even in 2040, when I was looking at some of the figures about a few days back, coal will be dominant there still. Almost 40% dependence will be on coal. So now you can understand how important the oil and gas will be. Now, scenario, if you see oil and gas, this 30%, 33% will not change. Even it is 2040, even though it's 2020. Even after 20 years, the oil, gas, energy basket, we will be having only 32 to 33%. Only change will be oil will be less, but the gas will be more. So gas will be doubled from 4, it will go to 8, but oil will reduce by 4. So the overall scenario of oil and gas is there. The future in oil and gas is secured. So my students who are listening to me, it's a very challenging job. If you are thinking to come in oil and gas business, please come. You will enjoy your life. You will enjoy the business. And it is one of the, I can say, totally different perspectives it will give to you. If I talk about world, the results about the gas, if the world results in the gas is 197 TCM, trillion cubic meter, whereas India has only 1.3, not even 0.5%. See the condition what we have, and that is the reason. That is the reason why we have to explore more and more. If you see, government is trying to come up with some of the ideas, new schemes that people come forward to explore more and more, find out and produce for the country. If you see the worldwide, the reserves which are available, Russia, Iran and Qatar, almost they have most of the reserves with them. Now I have given R by P oil, that is reserves oblique production ratio. If we are producing at the current rate, the oil in some of the countries will exhaust in 11 years, in some of the countries it will be 136 years. So now you can say, now you can understand with this slide, yes, this is not going to finish in maybe 20 or 30 years. Because why I'm giving this RYP ratio is, when we joined this industry in 1982, we were being told, 20-30 saal mein pura tel khatam ho jayega, iske baad kya karenge? 36 saal toh maine naukri kar li, aur aaj bhi mujhe पूरी तरह से मालूम है ओएनजीसी 36 साल आगे तक उसके बाद रिजर्व्स है. सो आप ये मत सोचिए, डोंट बॉक डाउन बाय द पीपल व्हाट दे आर टॉकिंग, गो बाय द फिगर, सी द थिंग्स एंड डिसाइड. नाउ व्हाट आर द फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्ट्स इन दिस इंडस्ट्री. आई हैव गिवन द सम ऑफ द स्वॉट एनालिसिस हियर. द स्ट्रेंथ, इफ यू सी द डोमिनेंट इन एनर्जी बास्केट मोर देन 55%, आई हैव टेकन वर्ल्ड वाइड. But if in Indian context, about 33 to 34%, this is a 1/3 of the energy is going to come from oil and gas. So can anybody see that we can ignore? No, this is required. So only thing, the gas percentage will increase. The weakness is fluctuation in oil and gas price. I think Divakar sir was talking about, and some of my friends were talking about, the prices went very low, even $1 a barrel. But that was for a day or two, because there are some future contracts. People buy oil for as per the future requirement. But now if a condition comes that you have to take the physical deliveries, you are not in a position to take the physical deliveries. That is the reason these oil deals were being sold. You said, I can't take physical deliveries. You take some money from me, you just keep it with you. So that kind of thing. You don't think that oil was available at $1 or $1.7 with the figure which we have seen. Even in the India, what the reserves, strategic reserves, somebody was talking about 6.5 MMT, that we have bought at the rate about $20 to $30 per barrel. So nobody has got this $1.3 or $1.4 per barrel kitty with them. No, not a single country. Only some of the countries who are buying from the Canada, they have got that opportunity. Otherwise, nobody else. So even the minimum price on which we OMC's oil marketing companies have purchased the crude oil was about 22 barrels, US dollar per barrel. So that was the average price which we have, which we have got this. Now opportunity is tremendous. If you see, one thing we call is a recovery factor. Suppose you have an oil of 100 ton oil available. Till today, the world best field has not even produced more than 50% from that. So challenge is now the new technologies. So there's a lot of opportunities. When we came in this industry, people used to say that if it, the recovery is about 30 to 32%, it's a very good recovery. But no, people talk about now 60 to 70% of the recovery. So my friends, there's a lot of opportunities. Technologies you have to develop so that we can produce this oil which is below the earth. So there's a lot of opportunities available. Now, other thing, the equipments which we are using. Previously, old manual equipments were there. Now, the lot of now robotics and things have come. And now, that day, Salil was also talking about some of the things. So, if you improve on our equipment side, definitely the efficiency is going to improve. If efficiency improves, it means the cost of production will also come down. So, these are the opportunities available. You can go ahead with the new technologies and we can improve on our mechanical part, efficiency part. And other opportunities, a lot of reserves are untapped, which I told that 26 basins, only 8 explored. So there's a lot of reserves are available. So a lot of opportunities exist in oil and gas. The threat is renewable energy and electric vehicles. Now, I'll talk on this. Renewable energy, if you see in total energy basket, is about 25%. And this 25%, if you see the world scenario, even in 2040, even I have seen some of the BP's site, even in 2060s, people talk about 25 to 27%. That's all. So this is not a threat at all. And about the electrical vehicle, I'll talk. People talk about the electrical vehicle will come, and if you, somebody might have heard about Tony Seba, he is after this, and even my chairman has given 3 books to me on Tony Seba, but I don't agree with that, absolutely not. Why? Simple reason is, I spoke to you about IC engines. IC engines, definitely my engineer friends will come up with better efficient engines, and this electrical business will go ahead. Number two, I already told, producing electricity with the coal and running an electrical vehicle is not an economical proposition as far as the environment is concerned. Number three thing, if you see as on today, in worldwide, there are 1.2 billion vehicles are available. And people project that by 2035, it will be about 2 billion vehicles. Now to replace these vehicles, and what is the production worldwide? I'm talking about worldwide scenario. Only 90 million vehicles we are producing worldwide. Now you can see how much time it is going to take. Lot of time. So friends, don't worry about this. This oil and gas business is going to remain here. There is no threat, whether it is a renewable or whether it's electrical vehicle. So there is no threat at all. The future prospects are very bright, and any energy basket, anywhere worldwide, if you see, this is going to remain at about 50%, but Indian context, it will be about 33%. So this is, I talked about the future prospects and the electrical vehicle, because some of the people think in their mind, oh, ye to electrical vehicles aa jayenge to hum ye gaadi ko kaise chalayenge, to uski chinta na kariye, wo jab chalne wala hai. But abhi, if you see the aviation, there is a lot of time somebody they will think about renewable energy to be used for aviation in place of aviation fluid. So this is another scenario which I'm just giving to you. Somebody has a question or should I go ahead? Okay. Now I'm just giving an overview how this oil and gas is being produced, because some of you might be thinking, I've given the scenario. So some of you might be thinking whether I should go in this business or not, whether I should choose my career to go in oil and gas business or not. So I will recommend that you must. There's a lot of thrill, and whatever learnings you have done in your college was going to help you to grow in this business. Now, I just given some of the figures. I'll explain those one by one. because how the oil is coming out from the, because sometimes when you talk about तेल से कुएं से तेल निकलता है, तो जब हम कुआं बोलते हैं तो हमारे दिमाग में आता है कि ये होगा जो बाल्टी लटकाते हैं उसे खींचते हैं या पंप लगा के पानी खींच लेते हैं. तो इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. द वेल्स आर, द ऑयल वेल्स आर डिफरेंट, एंड हाउ इट इज, हाउ वी फाइंड द ऑयल एंड हाउ वी प्रोड्यूस द ऑयल. आई एम जस्ट गिविंग ए वेरी क्विक ओवरव्यू ऑन दैट, देन आई विल गो टू सम वन मोर स्लाइड. आई हैव नॉट मेड मच स्लाइड्स. I am not very good in making slides, because like Salil, just that day we have seen last week. So I'm not very good in that. So because I have learned in my college with the slide rule only. So I am a man of slide rule, not a computer. So first thing which we do is seismic survey. Seismic survey, if you see the figure number one on top of you. So what the seismic survey does, it sends the waves. Wave is created from a vibratory track, or you just drill a hole and just blast something, so it will create a sound wave. Some of the waves will reflect, some of the waves will refract and will come back to the surface. So jab ye dekhe aap yahan pe, if you see this here, this is a collector track. So these waves are being collected here, and then the analysis is done by the geoscientist. What kind of formations are there, what kind of porosity, permeability will be there. So this is the thing which is being done. So that is a job for interpretation. So these data are collected. Once these data are collected, they are processed. And after processing, they tell us that these are the prospects where we can have oil and gas. It doesn't mean, and what is, how much oil and gas is there, that we'll learn next, what where it can be. So based on the finding of the interpretation done by the geoscientist, what is being done? We select a location where to drill, where the probability of oil and gas is there. So location is released, and once the location is released, then it is on the coordinates. But actually, you have to see the land, whether that land is available there, or the location which has been released. Can we do something on that place? Can we that is approachable, or if we, or it has to be made approachable, or there is some monument on top of that. So what is to be done? So these kind of things are to be done in the beginning. So once the land survey is done, and you know that yes, this is the place we have to drill to reach to this place. Which place? This is the place where we have to reach. So then the land is acquired, and if you see number two here, the well site, this is the well site. If you see the all around hillocks are there and things are there. So this site is prepared. Normally this site is about 150 meter by 100. But again, it depends what is your planning. Suppose if you're thinking that there may be very big reservoir, we can take a bigger land and we can drill more wells there. And that planning is done in the beginning itself. Then the rig is moved. This is the rig which is there on top here. If you see the rig, which is, this is there, this is the rig, we call it as a rig. Basically, it's a drilling machine, you can say that way. It is moved and the well is being drilled. So if you see the well, number three, the well drilling is going on. And how the well is drilled? If when you're drilling a well, aapne mere khayal se pani ka ya boring hote hue dekha hoga. It's a similar kind of thing. Only thing is here we have to see the pressures are higher, so we have to use a drilling fluid. And drilling fluid is nothing. If you see here, a pump is available here. The drilling fluid is prepared. The pump is pumping this from here. It goes down and comes up, and the same mud is cleaned, filtered, and again used by the same pump. So it's a closed cycle, basically. And why this is required? This is required because the pressure at the bottom is higher. So we have to create the hydrostatic head here in such a way that this oil and gas, or whatever is the formation fluid, it can be water, it can be oil and gas, it can be a mixture of oil and gas, it can be a mixture of oil, gas and water. So that can come into the wellbore. So to avoid that, we use this drilling fluid. Normally, in common language, this is called mud. And it has mainly bentonite and barite and some other chemicals which are being used for the lubrication and cooling purpose. So this is how the drilling operation is done. So there's a lot of career available for mechanical engineers to maintain these pumps, to maintain all these equipments. Drilling engineer is also a mechanical engineer. Even a production engineer who is recruited by the oil companies, they are also mechanical engineer and the production engineer. And some places we recruit chemical engineer for this purpose. And the chemical people can come in this mud business also. So once this well is drilled, that well is being tested. This is the well. If you see figure number 4, this is the well. Figure number 4, there are two things available. If you see two things, one is a well, white color, other is having some like a pump. So this well is producing by itself, because at the bottom the pressure here, if it is sufficient enough to push the oil and gas up, so that oil and gas comes up and it is being going to the refining station. But here the pressure at the subsurface is less. So like jaisa hum ghar mein pani khinchte hain pump laga ke, usi tarah se yahan pe SRP lagate hain, sucker rod pump isko bola jata hai. It's nothing but a pump hai, but hum jo usme chota valve lagate hain wahi system isme hai. Thoda sa isme mechanics zyada hai, kyunki pressure pe khel kaam karna hai isko, to isliye hame thodi si सीलिंग एंड ऑल अरेंजमेंट्स आर डिफरेंट. रॉड वही है, उसमें भी रॉड लगती है, इसमें भी रॉड लगती है, उसमें छोटी रॉड होती है, इसमें लंबी रॉड लगानी पड़ती है. तो वही सिमिलरली आप वहां से देख, बेसिक्स आर सेम, बट ओनली थिंग बिकॉज इट हैज टू वर्क एट अ डीपर डेप्थ, सो सम डिफरेंट अटैचमेंट्स आर बीइंग मेड. सो दिस इज यूज्ड व्हेन द ऑयल प्रेशर्स आर लेस एंड इट इज नॉट कमिंग अप बाय इट्स ओन. So these pumps are being used. Once this oil is produced, it goes to the refining station. These are the EPC, early production system we call it, or gas and oil refining places. It is not basically refining, but it is cleaning of oil and gas. This oil and gas which is coming up, it goes through a separator, and this separator removes the water, removes the oil and removes the gas. So oil is water which is going to a different tank, gas is being going to the different place through compressor in the pipeline, and oil goes to the storage tank where it is being stored, and then again it has been allowed to settle, and then it is being pumped to the refineries. So this setup is done by oil and gas people. So here again, if you see, a lot of equipments are there. In this place, you need a chemical engineers, because the oil which is coming, analysis to be done, how this to be separated. So a lot of chemical engineers are required. A lot of recruitments are being done here. And mechanical engineers are required, because a lot of things, and electrical engineers and the civil engineers are required to make this site and the project works. So a lot of opportunities are there. And nowadays, a lot of instrumentation is there. So instrumentation engineers also required there, and ENC guys, because we are taking everything online, so they are also scope. In oil and gas business, lot of opportunities for everybody, not only for one discipline. Each and every discipline has an opportunity here. Somebody is, I think, want to interrupt in bit. Any question, anybody? Because I heard some of the voices. No questions? So questions will come in the...
Till now, no questions.
Sir, we will be going to ask in the last...
Haan, theek hai, chale, theek hai. Okay, I understood. Kabhi-kabhi aise hota na, koi bolte rehta, do cheez hoti hai. Something goes in the head or something goes over the head. So, I don't know where it is going, but... I'm trying to make it to rotate your head. So now, some of the important learnings, which are very, very important if you are coming to the business or to your serving anywhere, either it's PSU or multinational or what. What normally I teach and what I and I advocate anywhere, wherever I go. The first thing is communication. Somebody asked me a question in one of the lecture which I was delivering in Bahrain. Sir, if you want to grow in this corporate culture, what is the important thing? I said, communication, communication, and communication. This is important. आप वो पिक्चर का डायलॉग याद मत कर लेना. आपको मैं तीन कम्युनिकेशन बोलने से कई बार ना वो एंटरटेनमेंट 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 when I talk about these three communications, these three communications are very, very clear in my mind. First communication is we should not afraid to talk to our seniors. Sometimes I have seen people have hesitation. No, why I should? No, sir, don't. No, never afraid. Don't have any vision. Number two, communication. Don't have any vision to talking to your colleagues. Sometimes what happens, everybody is not expert. बहुत लोगों को कुछ बहुत सारी चीजें नहीं मालूम. मुझे भी नहीं मालूम है बहुत सारी चीजें. मैंने विवेक सर से बहुत कुछ सीखा. तो इट इज लाइक दैट. लर्निंग इज एट एवरी स्टेज. दैट एवरी वन ऑफ अस टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट. सो इफ यू हैव एनी विजन, मैं इसको यार क्यों बात करूं, ये तो मेरे बैच का ही है, मैं इससे क्यों बात करूंगा, ये दिमाग में नहीं होना चाहिए. डोंट हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ इनिबिशन इन योर माइंड. इफ दैट कम्युनिकेशन इज क्लियर, द थर्ड कम्युनिकेशन इज यू डोंट हैव एनी hesitation in talking to your junior colleagues. I don't call them subordinate. There's no subordinate, they're only junior colleagues, because I don't like the word subordinate. No, they are our junior colleagues, whether my students or my friends or whoever it is, who are not senior citizens as on today. I can say that way. So that hesitation should not be there. Why I should talk to a peon? I am a director and but friends, I have seen idea can come to anybody's mind. So that comfort can be given to a person only by communication. If he understand that if I say something, saab sunenge, to wo aapko kuch idea de sakta hai. Otherwise, you are plugging that. So friends, the best tool available to grow in your life or in your career or to become a director or chairman of a company, communication, communication, and communication is one of the biggest two. Another thing which I found, and it is happening most of the places, decision making. This is one of the important thing wherever you are. If you can't take decision, please don't take those positions. Decision taking is very, very important if you have to move forward, if you have to take your country forward, if you have to take your company forward, you have to take your families forward. Everywhere, this is important. No. If you are not able to take decisions, means you don't have that edge to become a director or a chairman of a company. And another very thing is positive thinking. There is nothing in this world which cannot be done. I will just tell you one thing here. When I joined in 1982 and I went to the rig, and only foreigners were there, all Goras, because they were the expert and we were in the industry very new, fresh from the college. And they used to rule us. And they used to tell us, they were not able to pronounce Mahavar, they used to call me VP. Maybe it will take 10 years to learn this. But I was having in the mind, because मैं यहाँ पे नाम देना चाहूंगा देवांगन सर का और हमारे उस समय पांडे सर थे. वो कभी बोलते यार कोई चीज ऐसी नहीं है जो आप नहीं कर सकते हो. तो मैं उनकी जो लर्निंग्स थे उसको मैंने लिया था कि नहीं, ये जब साला गोरा कर सकता हो तो मैं क्यों नहीं कर सकता इसको. And I given a challenge. In 1 year, you will be out from this place. This was the challenge given. And friends, 1 year, that was awesome. And we took that position. So it is, there is nothing which cannot be done. Only thing, वी हैव टू थिंक यस इट कैन बी डन. कभी कभी होता है, मैं यहाँ पे एक और एग्जांपल देता हूँ आपको इस पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग के बारे में. मैं क्लास 11 की बात कर रहा हूँ, वहां पे मेरे भटनागर सर हुआ करते थे और एक उन्होंने क्वेश्चन दिए थे कि ये सारे क्वेश्चन आप सॉल्व करके लेके आइएगा. मैंने एक क्वेश्चन को अटेम्प्ट ही नहीं किया, मुझे लगे ना बड़ा डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन है, इसको छोड़ो क्लास में समझेंगे. उन्होंने पूछा ये क्वेश्चन किया क्यों तुमने, मैंने कहा ये तो क्वेश्चन हो नहीं सकता, मतलब मेरे से नहीं हो सकता, मेरा कहने का ये था. ही जस्ट स्लैप्ड मी. आप सोच सकते 11वीं क्लास में मार खाया, लेकिन मैं घर रात को शाम को घर पे गया उनके, बिकॉज उनके जो शैलेंद्र भटनागर आप सब बहुत लोग जानते हैं, ही वाज वेरी 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 गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन एंड ही वाज हिज फादर. मैंने पूछा सर मेरे को मारा क्यों था, बोले तुमने ये क्यों नहीं बोला हो नहीं सकता. वंस यू हैव नॉट ट्राइड हाउ यू कैन से इट कैन नॉट बी डन. इफ यू हैड सेड आई हैव ट्राइड बट आई कुड नॉट डू इट, सो आई लर्न अनदर लेसन देयर. एनीथिंग फर्स्ट यू ट्राई योर सेल्फ, डोंट से इट यू होम. कभी होता है ना ये तो हो नहीं सकता, ये एटीट्यूड बिल्कुल नहीं होना चाहिए, किसी में भी नहीं होना चाहिए. इफ यू हैव दैट एटीट्यूड यू विल नॉट ग्रो. द अदर थिंग बिलीव इन योर सेल्फ. आप सोच रहे हो मेरा लेक्चर को ऑयल एंड गैस से निकल गया है, बट इस ऑयल एंड गैस में ये सब चीजों ने मुझे बहुत हेल्प किया एंड आई कुड सी एंड टूडे वेयर आई एम बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस लर्निंग्स इन माई लाइफ एंड फॉर माई सीनियर्स फॉर माई पेरेंट्स एंड माई कलीग्स. All these learnings have come. Believe in yourself. Boss, this is very, very important. ये आप मत सोचिए कि मेरे से नहीं हो सकता है. मैं इस चीज को इसलिए कह रहा हूं कि जब गोरे आते थे, अमेरिकन आते थे, मेरे रिक पे बोलते थे ये हो सकता है, मैं सोचता था कि हम क्यों नहीं कर सकते भाई. Why we cannot do it? They are also same persons. They are also having two ears, two eyes, two hands, two legs, everything same. Then why we cannot do it? Why we are dependent on them? क्यों हमें अपने ऊपर विश्वास की कमी? No, you can do much, much better than anybody else. That should be in your mind all the time. I have that in my mind. I can do, yes, and I believe in myself. And one thing, everybody should know that nobody knows yourself than better than you. Nobody knows. You yourself better than you. ये आप सोचे कि आप आपके में क्या कमी है वो आप अपने आप जानते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है कि आप नहीं जानते. Nobody is going to tell you that आप में क्या कमी है, ये आपको खुद पता होता है. Let us work on that. ये मैंने बोला आपको. Be confident and firm. Any decision, anything, firmly. I used to listen to the people. Sorry, I'll have just a glass. The way you speak will give you a confidence to your senior or your boss or your colleague that how sometimes, sir, ये हो सकता है, हो जाएगा. ये दोनों में फर्क है. Sir, yes, I will do it. But sir, थोड़ा मुश्किल होगा. So the confidence is that. Once you are confident, be firm on that. Yes, it will be done. When I came here, I am just talking about this fire. Minister called me and he said, Mr. Mahawar, I am going to PM today for a meeting. Secretary is also going. You tell me, can it be done? I said, yes, it will be done. No problem. With my experience, I can say this capping operation will be done. So that kind of confidence should be there within you. And that will come when you involve yourself in the work, in the organization. If you involve, you start enjoying your work, that involvement come, that confidence will come within you. But sometimes what happens, ठीक है मुझे तो नौकरी मिल गई ना, मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम मिल गया, अपना आराम से चलता हूँ, वो दूसरा कोई करेगा. वो दिमाग में बिल्कुल मत रखिए. If you want to grow, and this country needs that. That kind of attitude is required if you want ki Ram Raj aana chahiye ya desh ko badhna chahiye. Aap sochoge main thoda sa us tarah ki bhasha ka bol raha hu, but ye bahut zaruri hai. Main ye meri apni learnings aap se share kar raha hu kyunki wo sab cheez aise nahi hai, ye kisi aur ka kaam nahi, hum sab ka kaam. And one another thing which I am sharing with you is Indian brain is logical. Friends, I have, after my retirement, I have visited about 12 countries. I am organizing some of the courses there for crisis management, for tender management, for inventory management. 2 days workshops. The kind of logical mind Indian have, nobody has. Nobody. जो जुगाड़ हम कर सकते हैं ना वो वर्ल्ड में कोई नहीं कर सकता, ये आपने दिमाग में बैठा लीजिए। मैं पूरे वर्ल्ड में घूम चुका हूँ, वर्ल्ड में ऑलमोस्ट मैं 22-23 कंट्रीज घूम चुका हूँ, बट मैंने देख लिया कि जिस तरह की लॉजिक की बात हम कर सकते हैं नहीं करते लोग, उसको फॉलो करते हैं, वो रिपीटेडली वही करते हैं। और हमारे अंदर एक लॉजिकल दिमाग माइंड होने की वजह से उससे हमको थोड़ी एक लर्निंग लेनी चाहिए, दिमाग में रखना जरूरी है, उसको पेपर में भी लाना जरूरी है। सो अदर कैन लर्न दिस, अदर कैन, सो दिस शेयरिंग काइंड ऑफ थिंग विल हैपन, आदर यू कंडक्ट सेमिनार्स, यू इंटरेक्ट विद द पीपल, और यू राइट इट डाउन। सो दैट विल हैपन ओनली व्हेन यू डू दिस। अनदर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, एप्रिशिएट ईच अदर। कभी कभी होता है ना, आपने बहुत सारे मेरे फ्रेंड्स हैं जो नौकरी में होंगे, अरे वो अकाउंट वाला क्या करता है यार, हिसाब किताब तो करता है, अरे मैं तो फील्ड में काम करता हूँ, ये मैं इतना फिजिकल वर्क करता हूँ, वो देखो वो तो प्लानिंग वाला क्या करता है। बट एवरी प्रोफेशन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, तो वी स्टार्ट अप्रिशिएटिंग ईच अदर। आप ये मत, ये वो क्या करता है, ये आप जहाँ है वो आपका काम है, but the other person sitting in office doing his job, that is also equally important. आप ऐसा मत सोचिए कि वो काम कर, ऐसा नहीं होता है। तो वो चीज दिमाग में कभी आनी नहीं चाहिए, अरे वो क्या करता है, मैं तो इतना फिजिकल वहां काम करता हूँ, बिकॉज आपका प्रोफेशन है, आप जिस लाइन आपने चूज की है वहां पर करना पड़ रहा है, बट दैट पर्सन हैज चूज़न अदर लाइन। सो लाइक अगर आप मेरे कुछ ऑयल में बैठे हुए फ्रेंड्स बोले बैठे होंगे, वो सोचते हैं अरे ड्रिलिंग उसमें तो बहुत मेहनत करनी पड़ती है, प्रोडक्शन उसमें कम मेहनत करनी पड़ती है, जियोलॉजिस्ट उसको क्या हो तो ये लाइनें पढ़नी है, बट दैट इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट, दिस इज रिक्वायर्ड देयर ऑल्सो। सो लेट अस अप्रिशिएट, बट वी डोंट अप्रिशिएट, हम क्रिटिसाइज ज्यादा कर देते हैं। सो प्लीज अप्रिशिएट, एक दूसरे को अप्रिशिएट करना सीखिए। इफ समबडी इज डूइंग गुड जॉब, सर जस्ट गिव अ पैट ऑन द बैक, दैट्स सिंपल, यू डन अ गुड जॉब, दैट्स ऑल, दैट इज ओनली रिक्वायर्ड। एंड आई हैव सीन दिस वर्क्स, whatever achievement I have done, this I always appreciate. Today, one of the director in ONGC, he was talking to me about 3-4 months back. Sir, I went to the rig when you were asset manager, I was in charge of that. You have given me 20 appreciation letter, and today I have seen when I visited there. So what it cost? Nothing. But the kind of moral boosting, kind of confidence building measure it does, it's very, very important. Another thing is think beyond full stop. आप सोचेंगे मैं बहुत सारे jargon use करता हूँ. Yes, this is required. Think beyond full stop. What we do is, we read the procedures, बोले सब इसके बाद तो कुछ लिखा ही नहीं है, what I should do? If you are in a position, when I talk about the senior position, or any other position, we don't think beyond that. You know that this is important, this job. मुझे ये मालूम है यहाँ को बुझाना है, इस वेल को कंट्रोल करना है. But my procedure says यहाँ इसके आगे तो मैं नहीं कर सकता. Why? Because procedure में लिखा नहीं है. Then who will do it? Somebody has to do it. And why don't you can do it? You do it and show that yes, I have courage to do this. That kind of passion should. In my life career of 36 years, there was nothing which was not done. I only asked, you just tell me what is the procedure, what is to be done. I just approved that and included. So that is thing beyond full stop. Yeh nahi ki aap full stop lag gaya, iske aage to kuch ho hi nahi sakta. Aisa nahi hota bhai. These procedures are being made by us only. Mere kisi dost ne banaya hoga. Aapke kisi dost ne banaya hoga. So why don't you, can't you have the courage to change it? Then who will come and do it? You think that somebody else will come and do it for you? No. When your problem is with you, you have to do it. That kind of approach we all should have. And this is, these are two things which is not pertaining to you, but normally I used to talk to them, talk to the well, talk to the reservoir. This blowout which has happened, the fire which has happened, if people have listened to the well, this should not have happened. And this I'll discuss in detail sometime. If somebody is interested, I'll give my mobile number or they can discuss with me. The last thing which I am telling is the power of Hanumanji. Why I am telling this power of Hanumanji? Logic ko samajhna padega. Because this works. बहुत अच्छे से काम करती है. अगर आपको याद होगा रामायण के बारे में, जो आपने सुना होगा, जब हनुमान जी को लंका जाना था तो बोले इतना बड़ा समुद्र को हम कैसे याद करेंगे, जब कैसे मैं जाऊंगा. उन्हें उनकी शक्तियां याद दिलाई. जामन जी ने कहा कि नहीं महा हनुमान जी, आप में वो शक्ति है कि आप एक स्टेप में इस पूरे समुद्र को लांघ के लंका जा सकते हो. जब हनुमान जी को ये शक्ति याद आ गई तो उन्होंने यूज किया उस शक्ति को और श्रीलंका जी लंका गए भी. तो ये शक्ति हम सब में है. We all have that power within us. Only the thing we have to see, चावला साहब को देखना है कि मेरे स्टूडेंट्स में ये शक्ति कैसे जाए. तो यहाँ पे ये बात बोलना चाह रहा हूँ कि how this power given to these can be reminded to the boys and girls who are studying in our college. So this is a very powerful tool. So whatever the important points which I have written, not related to oil and gas, but these are the practical things I thought, let me share with you. So at least the people, my friends, my junior colleagues who are studying in the college can, when come up, they have all these qualities within them and they excel everywhere. Like, मुझे भी अच्छा लगा कि यहाँ अच्छा college से है. तो आज जो यहाँ पे crisis management के head है, जो ONGC की तरफ से आया है, he is also from our college. Sanjay Bhatt, I think 88 or 87 batch में होंगे, मतलब सब में होंगे. So he is heading that thing, and now he is in the field. I wanted to be here for some times, but we were in the field, so he is not here. So, and this is the slide which I just wanted to show, and you wanted to know that what has happened in the well. If you see first place, number first figure. We were inspecting the lot of fire, about 100 meter in area around the well got burned. I just wanted to check whether how the burn, how much damage it has done. If you see all around, the trees burned and some of the place where I'm sitting here, tea bushes are there, they burned. But there is a superficial burn. If you see that I'm just removing the soil from the top, inside is a very clean soil. So it's a superficial burn. If you turn the soil up and down, you can work on it. The other figure, if you see, I'm looking at some of the trees, how much damage has been done to the trees. But aap dekhenge usme aapko pura fly, wo bhi dikh raha hai, flame kitna bada hai. And the third figure which you see here, I went very near to the well, 20 meter, because there was no water, I could not go very near, just to plan. What are the things needed for that? So, आप ऐसा try मत करिएगा अपने ऐसे जानने के लिए. Means you have an experience, then only you can go there. Because I have controlled many blowouts like this. I have almost controlled 33 blowouts worldwide, two outside India, some of three of Oil India, and some of the Indian companies and ONGC. So, I have experience of controlling this. And only thing which has given me strength, the basics taught by my teachers in my college and my school. So I give credit to them because they have cleared my basic, and that basics have paid me. Clearing of basics paid me. One learning I'll share with you, the thing which Mr. Devangan sir or Pandey sir mujhse kaha karte the, ki Mahavar ji aap puri kitab ko padha karo, important topics nahi padhna hai. Normally hum kya karte hai, ये पिछले साल ये तो क्वेश्चन आया था, इसमें से अब कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं आएगा, चैप्टर छोड़ देते हैं. डोंट हैव दैट हैबिट. प्लीज रीड कंप्लीट. ठीक है, वो नहीं आएगा तो प्रॉब्लम है, बट यू हैव टू गेन नॉलेज. नंबर्स नहीं कमाने हैं हमको, नॉलेज गेन करना. अगर आप उस एटीट्यूड के साथ पढ़ेंगे तो नंबर अपने आप आ जाएंगे। So I think almost I have taken more than 52 minutes. So with this, I end my presentation. And I don't know how useful it was, but from oil, it has come to different phase also. But anybody has any question, now this is open for all of you. So I'll just come back.
Thank you so much, sir, for an awesome and motivational presentation. It was a complete blend of both technical information and real-life inspiration. As Mahavar sir has told at start, no question is a silly question. So I request all of you to ask and share all your queries.
Can I also ask? Can I ask?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anybody can ask any question.
Sir, the production cost of crude oil in India, what is the figure and are we comparable with other nations of the world?
See, the production cost in India is, we should talk about offshore because I'm total cost I'm lifting cost, and if there's a, see, there's a lifting cost, it's about $3, $3 to $4. The refining cost, if you see the total cost without the taxes, it's well within $12. But when we add all the levies and taxes, cess and all these things, it comes out to be about 37 to 42. It depends on which field you are producing. Some field it is 36 and some field it is going up to $42.
Yeah. But we are efficient.
Basic
we
cost.
Are efficient enough.
Yeah.
That means, sir, we are efficient enough as compared to other countries also.
I'll not say efficient enough because the cost of production, if you talk about Saudi Arabia, it is $13 and there's no tax. So it depends what is the tax structure in the country, and that is the reason, because of this in the oil price scenario, the companies are asking for the tax rebate, because our cost is total cost which we are which is coming while out.
And sir, one more thing, sir. I'd read in papers, newspaper, in 1920, the overall production of crude oil was 32,000 TMT, and it was 18 years low. Though we are trying to improve our production to reduce import, but in 1920, it was 18 years low. What was the reason, sir?
Oil production or what? 1920.
Yeah.
See, at that time, only at that time, in India, the focus on oil came only after 1956 or 57, when OGC was formed and all. Before that, there was no focus. Only the Burma oil was there, they were producing oil. And it was not even 1 MMT. It was about 0.662 MMT, which I remember, yes. It is 662 or 667. That was the production at that time. And today we are producing about 35 MMT, million metric ton of oil, in country, total. So you see, from less than 1 to 35, we have come up. So definitely, during that period, no offshore discoveries, no onshore discoveries, only producing from one basin. Now we have 8 basins from where we are producing. And that is the reason the production has come up.
And what is the percentage of private players, sir? Private players are also there now in India.
Private players are there. Yeah, if you see the total scenario, about 70% of the oil is produced by ONGC and about 23% is produced by Oil India, and rest is produced by the private players.
Thank you so much, sir.
There are not much private players. Private players only Cane, which is producing about 3 MMT.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, one more question is there from our faculty, Dr. Kishore Saxena, sir. He wants to ask, being an electrical engineer, is that what is the maximum capacity of an individual electrical energy generator using oil or gas as energy? And is there any issue in feeding the generated energy to national grid?
See, if you see the scenario wise, the electricity का अगर मैं scenario आपको बता दूँ, तो about 38% जो बिजली पैदा देश में होती है, वो coal से होती है, और जो करीब 24% gas से होती है, और सिर्फ 4% oil से होती है. तो oil and gas का total percent is about 28% है, जो electricity produce करता है. एंड ये जो 28% है हमको इसको बढ़ाना चाहिए कोल के डिपेंडेंसी कम करके इस पे आना चाहिए तो इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियर्स के लिए प्रोड्यूसिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी फ्रॉम द गैस आई थिंक दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट थिंग फॉर दिस कंट्री कैन
थैंक यू सर
वी शुड गो फॉर इट व्हाट आई व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग इट टुडे द प्लांट व्हिच आई कमीशन इन 2014 सो इट वाज fully commissioned 2014, 726 megawatt. It is producing cheapest electricity in India. The cost of production electricity is about 2.3 rupees per unit, which is lowest any of the manufacturer or any of producer in India. Because the efficient machines are there. And it is producing electricity from the gas. So that is the reason. So the cost, if you want to bring down, this is the way we have to do it. So we should think of gas-based economy in this country.
Thank you, sir. Archana ma'am wants to ask something. Ma'am, please.
Sir. You told in the SWOT analysis that the threat is from electrical vehicle and with all the renewable energy sources. Is it possible that because the percentage of oil is only 22 units, while the coal for generating electricity is 250 units? So by using the latest technology, if we will convert the oil and gas percentage to generate more electricity and then that electricity will be used for the electrical vehicles. Then is this a good scenario? Then if we'll find out the chaining, like directly using the oil or petrol to the vehicles and finding out so many other aspects of that, like the pollution and all, and the scarcity of oil in that condition. And if we'll convert the oil and gas to the electricity and we can use the electrical vehicle more based on that electricity. So if you will calculate this cycle, so the next cycle, that means step one, the oil and gas, then convert into the electricity and then use electrical vehicle, is more perspective. So what are your comments on this, sir, apart from a threat, not a threat, but for the SWOT analysis only?
Archana, I think I have told in the beginning, base scenario, 38% electricity is produced from the coal.
Yeah.
You can use electricity from that coal and use it for e-vehicle. That is,
so you're not audible.
That is the ecological position. We definitely target more and more electricity production from gas. Oil is also still polluting. We are not using 100% oil is the gas. We should more focus gas-based power plant and gas-based plant can be used to even that is an economical position. This you can say total scenario. You see the total cycle. Yeah, definitely that helping to reduce the pollution in this globe. So this is definitely because there's a lot of gas available here. Even we have not explored the hydrates, which are in trillions of cubic meter available in this country itself. But this technology is not available. The challenge is to use that how we can produce this hydrate and which has trillions and trillions cubic meter available with us. Only Japan is doing some work and India done a petition on that. If you can work on that, definitely the next 100 years is a gas economy. We have to focus on gas, not that 8%, because I was looking at this and I spoke to NITI Aayog also, 50% is not enough. We should get at least 15% to 20% of gas-based economy, gas-based consumption in this country if you want to grow at a better GDP than what we see.
Right, sir. Another thing, sir, this is not the question, but apart from giving the scenario of oil extraction, the well and all, and the way you have given your aim and the targets of the life, they are really interesting. And I have noted down all the points what you have told me, and really the point I liked amongst all, that is the be confident, and second, talk to reservoir. That is the really good thing. I have accepted and I adopted from your speech that we need to talk to the way where we are. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ashna. Thank you very much. I think some learnings you are taking, it is good. I think I'm finding I have given a useful.
Yes, sir. Very nicely you explained in very easy language. And
I'll be interrupting here. I can see presence of my batchmate, Mr. Rajesh Parasar, and our distinguished alumni, Mr. Ashish Gore. I welcome them to this webinar.
Hello, sir.
Welcome, Rajesh. Welcome, Gore.
Thank you, Balvi.
Mahavar sir, मैं आपसे कुछ बात करना चाहूँगा सर.
हाँ जी बोलिए.
जैसा आपने बताया सर कि ऑयल और गैस इंडस्ट्री का फ्यूचर ब्राइट है, एटलीस्ट फॉर कमिंग 40-50 इयर्स, नो रिस्क.
यस.
तो सर ये आपका सेक्टर ऐसा सेक्टर है जहाँ बहुत हाई सैलरीज है, फास्ट ग्रोथ है, तो हमारे स्टूडेंट्स अगर उधर आना चाहें तो किस तरह की ट्रेनिंग, इंटर्नशिप, प्रोजेक्ट्स करें, काइंडली उसमें हम लोगों की हेल्प करिए. और अगर कोई ग्रुप कनेक्ट होना चाहे आपसे इसके लिए, प्लीज हेल्प देम.
Definitely no problem. If somebody wants to do internship in ONGC, still I have that approach. I can
great, sir.
I can provide to them. If anybody wants to discuss about this oil and gas scenario or any project you want to do, because I did PG person, the guy has done a research in Germany and he has published a paper in USA, which I could not do, but he did it. My company didn't permit me. So that kind of thing, if anybody wants, whatever learnings I have, I'm ready to share, I'm ready to guide them. And definitely I will be happy to do that. And I'll share my mobile number if you people want to note it. My mobile number is 9868282001. And my mail address is VP Mahavar, Victor Papa, Mike Alpha, Hotel Alpha, Whiskey Alpha Room, VP Mahavar @gmail.com. This is my mail address.
Thank you.
Just directly if you call normally unknown numbers, थोड़ा सा hesitant ज़्यादा मैं नहीं बताता हूँ. If you give a WhatsApp and separate time, this is my number.
Thank you, Mahavar sir, for this openness and transparency which you have shared with your juniors, students, and your friends. Another thing, being a technocrat, now you are holding position of in charge director IIM Rohtak.
Yeah.
So can you narrate some revolutionary change which you have brought in that institute by virtue of your long experience and commitment? Kindly throw some light.
Actually, IIM Rohtak, basically they were not having infrastructures. What we, the infrastructures which they were developing, after I became I went there, we expedited that. Now campus is fully functional. And apart from that, when I became an acting chairman of that, and still I'm acting chairman of that because they are not selected the chairman yet. So we have started another course there. MBA in sports, because we have not seen MBA in sports anywhere, and in Haryana, because it's in Haryana, you might have seen Haryana, a lot of people are very interested in sports and coming up. So we started MBA in sports in IIM Rohtak. This is the only institute where I am with this, this is there. And that we started with the visiting faculties. We are not having the full faculty till today, all visiting faculty. I think that kind of thing can be done in our college also. I think that day we were talking. So it could be a good, say, for our students coming up to start teaches with. It's not necessary to have a full-time lecturers or full-time people there. You can call people on hire, or you can have a contract with them. So that kind of thing can be done, and this is being done there. And this whole course is running very successfully. Almost 1.5 years, 2 years. Now it is 2 years completed. So yes, this is we are done.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, Vivek.
Huh. Thank you, sir. Anybody is having any other question can speak up or raise your hand. Okay. Sir wants to ask from Arun. Yes, sir, you can.
I just wanted some kind of scenarios. Presently, I'm in Saudi Arabia and heading a project of oil and gas as an interface manager. So I'm directly working on Aramco. So there was a Indian government and Aramco, there is merging, where it is having a largest refinery in Asia compared in Maharashtra. So, sir, can we put a light on that? It will be a beneficial for the new students.
See that
experience.
There are two refineries which are coming up, big refineries. One was in Barmer and one in Maharashtra. But there are some issues going on. If I talk about Barmer one, there it is coming up, which is with HPCL. That refinery work is going on, but Maharashtra work has not started. There were some local issues. Local people were having apprehension that if refinery, a lot of pollution will be there and this. But the talk is going on. And this refinery will definitely help, because Saudi Aramco, normally they do is they send the crude and they take the final product. The same thing they are doing with the Bahrain also. The refinery. Saudi crude comes there and then they get the refinery. They only get the refining charges, they call it. So that kind of thing is happening. Similar thing they wanted in India also. But that refinery has not even took off. But I know, because of the political and now the different government is there. So I'm apprehensive that whether this project will take off or not. But it definitely is going to open a lot of opportunities for our young engineers if it comes up. It will be one of the biggest refinery in India after their lives.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Any other question?
I think Rajesh Parashar wanted to ask. He raised the hand.
Okay, Rajesh, sir, you can ask. Rajesh, sir, I think please unmute your mic, sir.
Hello.
Hello. Bole Rajesh ji.
Haan, sir. Namaste. Namaste, sir. Umeed hai aap mujhe yaad rakhe honge.
Main sabko yaad rakha hu.
So, sir, mera prashn ye tha ki Bharat ke sandarbh mein jo hamari energy scenario hai. हमारे पास बहुत ज्यादा ऑयल रिसोर्सेज नहीं है, क्या हमें अल्टरनेटिव सोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी पर ज्यादा फोकस नहीं करना चाहिए बजाय ऑयल एंड गैस के?
नहीं, डेफिनेटली देखिए, अगर आप बात करेंगे ऑयल एंड गैस में हम करीब करीब ऑयल जो 86% ऑयल हम करीब इम्पोर्ट ही कर रहे हैं, 14% ही प्रोड्यूस कर पा रहे हैं. अगर आपके खनिज संपदा आपके पास अवेलेबल है, सपोज गैस इज अवेलेबल, व्हाई आई शुड इम्पोर्ट गैस? अगर हम गैस जो हम इंपोर्ट करते हैं, आपको पता होगा कि हम एलएनजी के रूप में उसको लेते हैं, लिक्विड नाइट्रोजन. तो एलएनजी कॉस्ट इज मच हायर देन द गैस व्हिच यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग. द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट ऑफ द गैस इज अबाउट $2, अप्रोक्सीमेटली $2.2 पर MMBTU, वेयर एज द एलएनजी व्हिच यू आर इंपोर्टिंग इज अबाउट $6 पर MMBTU. सो नाउ दैट एलएनजी इज कमिंग अगेन, वी आर डीगैसिफाइंग एंड डूइंग इट. सो आई थिंक If you see that scenario, not only on oil front, okay, that gas front, that is, and whatever the, you know, oil available with us, definitely we should extract. The cost is less, and whatever, even if you are giving a sales revenue, all these things, and that helps in developing our countries, creating jobs for the country. And it is my personal opinion, we should explore our energy sources which are available with us. Definitely, yes. If you are focusing only on the renewables already, you know, if you talk about solar energy, a lot of land is required for that, and all these maintenance issues are there. And even in the, if you see the Rajasthan and all these places, this wind energy is being used, wind power machines are there. But the wind speed, what we are getting here, with that we are not getting the kind of output which we should get otherwise. So that kind of issues are there. But in, otherwise, oil and gas, we definitely should go and extract. It is my opinion, and if we, the country has to grow.
इसमें दो चीजें हैं. एक हमारे पास लैंड की बहुत ज्यादा शॉर्टेज है जिसमें हम रिन्यूएबल्स लाइक सोलर वगैरह को नहीं इस्तेमाल
कर सकते,
बहुत एक्सपांड नहीं कर सकते. पर हमारे पास एक बहुत 7000 किलोमीटर लंबी शोर लाइन है, क्या हम टाइडल पे काम नहीं कर सकते?
सी, इस पे काम चल रहा है, टाइडल पे काम चल रहा है. एंड दे आर ट्राइंग आल्सो सम ऑफ द एनर्जी सोर्सेज और इवन द विंड पावर मशीन ऑफशोर आल्सो गोइंग अहेड. But the cost of installation, if you see from that angle, and the efficiency of the machines which you have, has been studied, the cost is coming very high. It's about 9 rupees per unit, which is coming up. And nowadays, if you talk about solar, the cost, which was about 13 to 14 rupees per unit, has come down to even 2.3 rupees per unit. So that is the reason that is not taking off. Let some more technology evolve. And when these technologies will evolve, like in solar, I think these winding and tidal power can be utilized. But it will take some time, definitely, yes.
Yes, definitely.
But our energy requirement is very, huge, and it is growing at the rate of about 2 to 3%. And whereas the oil growth rate is almost, it's not even a percent. So if you see the renewable growth in this country is about 3 to 4%, which is matching with that. So definitely work on renewable is going on. So these renewables will be there in future, but energy requirement is also increasing accordingly. That's why the percentage share will not change from 25 to 27. It will be in that same range only.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Archana ma'am, you want to ask some other question?
Archana, your mic is mute.
Regarding this answer only, what sir has given, I want to ask, like we have for thermal power, we have one corporation, NTPC. For oil and gas, we have ONGCs for the extraction and all. Why we don't have this type of public sector for solar energy? Or for the non-renewable energy, like this department for the thermal, for the nuclear power corporation is also there. Can't we go for it? Because the land, concerned land, is what is required for the solar plant is also there. We have a such a beautiful sunlight with a very almost 8 months or 9 months of the year. So this type of corporation or public sector has not been formed. Maybe, can you put some light on this?
Yeah, Archana, I think you're right. There's no public sector for these renewables. Some of renewables they are there. But the oil and gas companies, and they are being asked to have their share in renewables. Like ONGC, they have set up a solar power plant, they have a wind power plant. During my period, I have installed up 110 megawatt power plant, Jaisalmer. And we have 84 megawatt plant, which, so like that, these companies, issues are being asked that your share in renewable should be there, and how much that you decide that you have to work on that. All the companies, they are working towards that. there's no separate entity, but 60 entities like OBC and ILP and all this, they are working on that and they're separate.
Thank you. Sir, one last question from a student. Rupesh wants to ask some question. Rupesh?
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir, for taking the topic from your renewable energy resources. Sir, I want to ask one thing, that the tragedy that happens in Assam of having a fire in oil well. So, sir, it was in news that they were taking help of foreign countries to extinguish the fire. So I want to know that in your lifetime experience in oil and gas industries, have you ever faced such accidents? And if so, then why Indian technologies or by India itself cannot distinguish that fire, oil fire, sir?
Sir, my friend, I think I share my experience. I have fight the fire bigger than this. That is Tuscaloosa in 1995. The fire, the flow was much more than this, and the flame height was about 103 meters. Here it is only 60 meters. So that kind of thing was done by us, but. Why foreign expert is required? Because these things we are not doing it on daily basis. And the foreign experts, there are only 4 companies in the world who is doing this kind of job. And they are called by each and every company. ONGC is the only company in the world which has the crisis management team of its own. No company in the world has the crisis management team who can have this kind of setup and the team who can fight the fire. Today itself, today if you talk about this scenario, we were capable of doing it. Definitely, yes. And if you talk about me, I have personal opinion that this fire is not a big fire. And for me, at least, maybe for the people, it will be a big fire. And for me, it is not a big fire. And it can be controlled easily with whatever we have in India. But there were some other reasons for which the experts have been called. One thing I'll share here, all the equipments needed for this fire are available within India, and most of them, about 80 to 90% in ONGC. So that equipments have been mobilized. So in India, we have 4 work centers in ONGC. During my time when I was at crisis management team, we have set up this. With that thing in mind, that if something happens, why we should call people from outside. So during my tenure, when I was head of the crisis management team, similar kind of blowouts I have handled, but we have never called any experts from outside. So again, it depends on what is your confidence. How you say, yes, I don't need, means I don't need. So that is the confidence needed, which I was sharing with you. So this is the scenario at present. They have been called. The person has to take responsibility. If you don't want to take responsibility, okay, then you need somebody to help.
Thank you, sir. DP ma'am, you can continue now.
Vivek, I want to ask some questions.
I think Umesh, he wants to ask
him. Sir, good afternoon, and you have presented a beautiful insight into the oil and gas industries, and particularly your last slide was the Jeevan Ka Saar. So, ek point hamare liye to wo bahut important hai. So, follow karke one can actually grow in their professional life. I think they're very important and very, it's a summarized version of your overall experience, I think. Sir, mere ek bahut silly question hai, but since you said ki wo silly questions bhi question hai, at least, so main aapse ye puchna chah raha
tha. No question is a silly question.
Most of the refinery hum log jab dekhte hain ki that there is a small fire always on, you know, so cannot we have a technology we can use that energy into some productive form rather than getting it wasted? Or I don't know the exact rationale, but I think you can tell us something about it.
Yes, Umesh, you're right. This is basically called as a technical flaring. Yeah. People call it as a technical flaring. We can't make it almost zero, but we have reduced. If you see in OGC also, we were having a flaring was about 10 to 11%. And during my tenure, I have brought it to about 3 to 4%. Because there are technologies available, cost involved, but more than the cost, the energy which you are saving and using for the industry, that is important. So with that concept, we have reduced it. This technical fairing can be reduced by implementing some cost. But there you need not to see. So balance used to be made between the environment and the flaring. So if you're concerned about the environment, definitely that energy can be definitely captured and can be utilized everywhere. So we are working on that. In ONGC, this drastically, during my tenure, we have reduced it because I am very much concerned about the environment. And if you want that our future generation who is sitting in front of us and some of those who are listening to us, if they have to survive in a good environment, this is to be, we all have to think. Haji, Arun ji.
Sir, I'd like to ask one question as you are talking on the environment. सर हम लोग भी सीमेंट प्लांट में हैं और सीमेंट प्लांट जो है बदनाम किए जाते हैं दुनिया में सबसे ज़्यादा पॉल्यूशन करने के लिए और मैं ये बोलूँगा सर हम लोग भी यूज़ क्या कर रहे हैं बेसिकली बदनाम सीमेंट प्लांट हम लोग यूज़ कर रहे हैं कोयला यूज़ कर रहे हैं गैस यूज़ कर रहे हैं क्रूड तो बेसिकली हम लोग फॉसिल फ्यूल यूज़ कर रहे हैं सर बहुत सी टेक्नोलॉजी आई है सीमेंट में जहाँ के हमने पॉल्यूशन काफ़ी कम कर लिया अगर आप ओवरऑल पॉल्यूशन देखेंगे सीमेंट प्लांट का तो आज के जो 30 साल पहले जो स्टैंडर्ड थे उससे हम लोग 50% पे आ गए हैं और अभी जो अल्टरनेट फ्यूल और अल्टरनेट सीमेंट और उसमें हम लोग शायद 30% तक पहुंचने का टारगेट है सर हम लोग बहुत चीज़ों में बहुत सारी टेक्नोलॉजी लेके आ गए सर मेरा क्वेश्चन ऐसा है कि मैं जानता हूँ इट्स इम्पॉसिबल टू आंसर और इम्पॉसिबल टू हैव दैट थिंग बट क्या कुछ ऐसा काम चल रहा है कि जो फॉसिल फ्यूल से जो पॉल्यूशन जनरेट होता है जैसे सपोज एक किलो गैस को जलाने से इतना CO2 है या एक किलो कोयले को जलाने से इतना CO2 है उसको जलाने से हमारा पॉल्यूशन कैसे कम होगा इस टेक्नोलॉजी पर कोई काम दुनिया में चल रहा है क्या सर
सी दिस कैप्चरिंग ऑफ CO2 दैट वर्क इज गोइंग ऑन
सर कैप्चरिंग आई एम गोइंग सर आई एम सेइंग नॉट कैप्चरिंग सर कैप्चरिंग वी नो वी आर डूइंग वेरी गुड सो माय क्वेश्चन कि बर्निंग से CO2 कम पैदा हो ऐसी कुछ टेक्नोलॉजी आ रही है क्या
नहीं नहीं अभी ऐसी कुछ मेरे नॉलेज में भी नहीं है कि इस तरह से कुछ है टेक्नोलॉजी But only thing is, if you are using gas in place of coal, definitely the pollution will be much, much lesser than that. If you see in terms of percentage, you reduce about 70% pollution if you, in place of coal if you are using gas. That yes, statistics is available.
That's right.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Anybody has it?
Thank you, sir. Deepi ma'am, now you can continue.
Thank you, Vivek sir. Moving ahead with student feedback session, I would like to call Dhani Ram Sao, our student of 6th semester mechanical engineering, to share his experience regarding this session with all of us. Dhani.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, ma'am. Firstly, I would like to thanks to you to give us your most valuable time. At present, you have warned us by explaining the situation of oil and gas and also future prospect. We assure you that we fulfill our duty by using oil properly. Your lecture is also important for us because through this lecture you gave us the information to make a career in the oil industry. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dhani. Next in the series, Abhinav Tiwari, student of 8th semester mechanical engineering. Abhinav, please.
Thank you, ma'am, for the opportunity. Respected guest speaker, sir, respected chief guest.
Hello.
Hello, Abhinav, please unmute your mic, Abhinav.
Very good afternoon to all of you, sir. Respected guest speaker, sir. Respected chief guest, sir. Respected alumni and respected principal, sir. And respected professors and all my dear friends. Sir, it is our honor and privilege to have you, sir. First of all, I must thank you for breaking the myth that the future of oil is going to end in the next 15 years. In today's webinar, the most striking point was that only that there is a future of oil from 60 years from now also. And secondly, it was a very interesting session where you have put light on some of the most interesting facts about efficiency, that we are only consuming about 25 to 27%, that we are not reaching up to 50% also, and there is much opportunities in the oil field also. And next, sir, the most important part was the personality traits which you have put in today's webinar. I think that personality traits was the only trait because of you. We can understand your journey, that why you have journey so long from where to where. So thank you so much, sir, for your webinar. We have gained a lot of things from this webinar. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Avino. Moving in the same series, I would like to call Rupesh Chandrapal, student of 8th semester mechanical engineering, to share his view. Rupesh?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, all of you who are listening to me. Myself, Rupesh, from mechanical. Thank you, sir, for taking your precious time to speak with us. And now we had a clear vision about the scope in oil and gas industries. We also learned so many things, your values, that to be open, to be confident in ourselves and believing in ourselves. So now, being a future engineer, definitely we will try to develop new technologies that for increasing the efficiency of the oil industries. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rupesh. At the end, I would like to call Saket Dubey, mining 6th semester student, to sum up the student feedback session. Saket?
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, our chief guest Divakar Mishra, sir. Respected Ved Prakash Mahavar, sir, principal, sir, all alumni, all HODs and faculties and student. I am Saket Dubey from Mining Engineering 6th SEM, GC Bilaspur. Sir, we are very privileged to have listened to you, sir. The webinar was very insightful and interactive. I found this webinar very interesting, informative and useful. Thank you for giving us your valuable time, sir, and sharing your experience and knowledge to us about oil and gases and future aspect and career in this field, and engaging us all so that we can utilize our lockdown period to a fruitful time. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Saket. Now, moving forward, it's a great honor to invite Mr. Sushil Sinha, Vice President, Reliance Industries Limited, and our 1981 batch alumni of Mechanical Engineering for his concluding remarks.
नमस्कार. इतना एब्जॉर्बिंग डिस्कशन पहली बार सुनने में मिला, जिसमें कि एक बार पुनः अपने क्लासरूम में बैठने का आनंद आ गया. महावर साहब ने शुरुआत बिल्कुल टेक्निकल की थी, पर जिस ढंग से उन्होंने अपने स्टूडेंट्स को, वी ऑल वेयर द स्टूडेंट्स दिस टाइम, बहुत ही अच्छे से अपने साथ लेके चला, उसके लिए उन्हें साधुवाद, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. इस कार्यक्रम के होस्ट मिस्टर विवेक सिंह राठौर, प्रोफेसर डीपी सिंह, चीफ गेस्ट मिस्टर दिवाकर मिश्रा, अदर एलुमनाई फ्रॉम डिफरेंट प्लेसेस हु हैव जॉइंड दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन, माय डियर क्लासमेट मिस्टर राजेश पराशर, नाइस टू सी यू हियर,
नाइस टू सी यू
फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू प्रोवाइड ए क्लोजिंग रिमार्क. Though before me, a lot of people have spoken about the session, and that leaves a real difficult task for me at the end, how to sum it up, because most of the things have already been spoken about this particular session. But nevertheless, I will try my best to sum up some of the discussions point and the opinion which have been shared during this discussion. So I would start with few things about Mr. Mahavar. There were few questions from the students and faculty about how to control the wells. And I would like to tell this gathering of August people, including the students, that Mr. Mahavar in ONGC has the distinction of pioneering the critical well control expertise. In fact, he was made the first in charge for that particular crack team, which was responsible for tackling such kind of the wild wells which really spew venomous, you can say, whether the venom or the smoke or the gas and the oil. So a person who has dedicated his life for entire professional life in controlling the wildfire, if I recall that there are 35 to 36 incidences in ONGC where he was actively involved and led the fight from front. So his ability on that regard is unquestionable, and he has been entrusted with this particular task in Assam that clearly brings up the capability of that gentleman, the thorough gentleman, what he is, a thorough professional gentleman. He has the ability to build the caring relationship which you might have experienced while he was speaking with the students or all of us. He encouraged the people to ask the questions. He talked about his values and behaviors in detail. He has the deep knowledge and he is passionate about his activities and work. So once the person becomes passionate about his activities and work, no one can challenge about his ability to perform the task and to deliver the things what the management asks or what he has himself decided. At one place he talked about that particular thing also, that nothing can stop you if you have, you can decide that yes, it has to be done. And if you cannot do, who else is going to do? That is a famous quote from Sam Pitroda also. It is Indians who have to do it, and there is no one else who is going to do. As far as technology development in the unconventional sector is there, yes, that is going on. We have to go a lot of many miles in that area, but things have improved in the recent past, and we have seen a lot of proportion of the unconventional energy finding its way into the energy basket of India. If you recall, when did this oil business started in India? It was somewhere in 1889, and now we are in 1920. In between, we have forayed in multiple areas, not only in India, but outside the India in search of energy to make our country self-reliant. And as Mahavar Sahib was telling, that still we depend for the primary energy resources, 45% comes, we can only develop it. It is a purely an energy importer in that case. During the discussion, he talked about the SWOT analysis of the energy sector. He also talked about the challenges which the energy sector is facing as of now. Energy sector is very, very cost incentive intensive. New technologies are coming up, but they are not very, very fast to improve upon the productivity, reliability, and continuity of the operations. Lots of reserves are untapped, that is what Mr. Mahavar told. So that gives a confidence to the engineers who are currently studying in the institutes that yes, time is not gone. It is still there, and for at least coming 30 to 40 years, oil and gas is not going anywhere. It will be there, and the challenging work environment, it will always be there. So I can correlate this oil and gas business just next to the our forces, because the challenge which are here, the responsibilities and the risk factor which is here, it is enormous. And the risk is always, I can say that whenever people are working in oil and gas industry, they are sitting on the, wo bolte hai na ki barood ke dher pe baithe hain. Ek bhi procedure and process agar idhar se udhar hota hai, to turant wo chingari ka kaam karti hai. Aur ye kaise bhaya hua dawa nal ke roop mein convert ho jati hai ki usko control karna muskil hota hai. Aur wo aap log pichle ek mahine se sun rahe honge about the fire in the Assam area, where the first oil was found in that particular area, and that was the first. Furthermore, he talked about a lot of insight how the people can develop their self-confidence, and that is particularly important for our all budding engineers who are about on the threshold of completing their degrees and going into the market, testing themselves where they can find themselves fit. Positive thinking is one of the things which Mahavar Sahib stressed upon. Believe in yourself. That is the great thing. Appreciate each other and be a logical Indian. Indians are everywhere treated with respect. They are being seen as one of the light torch bearer of the knowledge. If you recall, in most of the Gulf countries, the earlier teachers were the Indians, and most of the teachers were teaching mathematics and physics. So that is the area where we are. So please inculcate those qualities, continue to harbor on those qualities. Certainly the future belongs to you. Few of the things people asked, which Mahavar Sahib also encouraged people to talk about, the questions. Questions provide information that can improve either your personal life or professional life. I do not
Hello. Vivek, sir?
Yes, ma'am. I think.
Sir, got discontinued.
I'm sorry, I was disconnected. There was problem with the internet, and this is what I'm feeling it very, very frequently today. So this is where the technology comes into play. Yeah. So I do not know, because a lot of consumption of the bandwidth is taking place. So everybody is working from the home. So certainly the available infrastructure is not able to cope up with the requirement. That is what it appears. So I was talking about the questions. So please don't feel at any time any hesitation in asking the questions. But mind it, questions should not be in yes or no type of. Because if you are asking yes or no, then you are not getting any insight in the problem. Always ask a sort of the questions which are open, because the open questions provide more insight in the challenges and the problems. Don't limit yourself to listening to yes or no. Continue asking follow-up questions. So I admire, I think, Lipika. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, I just missed the name. But anyway, she has been asking the questions and then follow-up questions and the follow-up questions. That is what it was.
Ritika was there. Ritika. During
yeah, artificial maybe. Intelligence. I'm sorry for the wrong pronunciation. Archana. Yeah, Archana.
Archana was
there. Yeah. Yeah, Archana asked the many questions, and I think continue at that. I think that is quite correct, and this should be learned by all other people, all other students also. So that gives you. And before closing this, on the question of asking only, children ask 125 questions per day. How many do we really ask? We ask, as per the study, 6 questions per day. So all my dear students, curiosity helps us to survive, gives happiness, boosts achievements, expands empathy, and increases the productivity. My best wishes with all, and once again, thanks to all the audience and Mr. Mahavar sir. Thank you, Mr. Chawla.
Thank you
so much, sir, for a beautiful sum up. Now, with equal pleasure, I would like to invite Dr. Anil Kumar Shukla, TechQ Coordinator, GEC Bilaspur, for vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible?
Yeah.
So, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to give you a vote of thanks on behalf of GEC Bilaspur, and on my personal behalf, I extend my sincere thanks to Sri Ved Prakash Mahavar sir, former director of ONGC and OMPL, for devoting his precious time to talk with the students. And sir, you gave us very useful information, like you discuss about the share of oil production, that is 0.5% of the world in India. You also gave us the information that gas reserve is around 1%, less than 1%. And you talked one very important thing that everybody was fearing that in coming 20 to 25 years, our oil reserve will deplete, and there'll be a lot of crisis, and this oil and gas sector will have no value. So you have told that there's great future, and for oil it is 11 to 136 year life is available. For gas it is 20 to 109. So for the students, there is no fear for this, and still they can go in this field for their job career. Also, you told us one thing that our recovery is very low. That is 30 to 32%, and expectation is 60 to 65%. To fill this gap, technology is required, and so the more and more engineers are required. So this is a good opportunity for our students. And also, you talked about some motivation to the students, and these motivations, these are some highlights that nobody knows you better than yourself. Before giving up, try and then think beyond first stop. These are some lines which appeared, that these are not only the lines for you, you have lived these lines. So our students should learn that really these experiences will help them to groom their future. So thank you, sir, for giving this valuable talk. Next, I would like to thank Sri Divakar Misra Sirji, SPIU Chhattisgarh, for his constant support and guidance. And also, many, many thanks to Sri Sushil Sinha, sir. Sir, you have very nicely summed up this talk, and you have given some important points as a takeaway for the students. I also extend my heartfelt thanks to Dr. B.S. Chawla for arranging and taking initiative to conduct this global talk series. And this is a very great initiative, sir. And particularly at this time, I say that you have converted this COVID fear into opportunity to the student. Our alumni are having time, and they're giving their time, and our students are using it fully through these webinars. I'm also thankful to Sri Umesh Srivastava ji. Umesh, you are 1 year junior to me, but I feel honored to address you as sir. You have contributed a lot. I'm seeing for the last 7 to 8 webinars, lectures, you are constantly involved, and you are giving a lot of time. So from on behalf of my institute, I salute you. I thank Deepi and Vivek. I would say that you are an indispensable component of this webinar series. Without both of you, it is very difficult for us to continue. And last but not least, all the students in the organizing team, and also all the participating students, it is a very good opportunity. And because of your zeal and enthusiasm, we are able to successfully complete this event. And you are a great source of inspiration for all of us. So utilize this opportunity fully. And one thing I would like to share to my student, during our time, there was no concept of alumni. Rather, I should say that this concept was not popular. But now, in our institute, we are having a very strong network of alumni, and they are supporting well. So students, it is my advice to you that take the full advantage of this. So with that, I once again thank all the contributing members, all the alumni, all the guests. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for all your words. So here we come to the end of our webinar. Before wrapping up, I extend my sincere thanks to one and all presented, and wish you a great day ahead. Thank you so much, everyone.
Okay, thank you,
Deepi ma'am.
I don't deserve that kind of appreciation.